pretty girls. Wipe the floor with all the boys. Pour the drinks, bring the noise.
It's Nikki Iggs.
I'm just so pretty.
Channel. So in today's video, we are doing something really, really, really bronzy and really, really like just glowy and bronzy. It's right in time for the summertime, and the glow never goes out of season. You can be glowing all year round, which I really like to do. But this particular video is mainly about the metallic lips. Now, the metallic liquid lipstick has been going around for probably about the last month or so. Milani Cosmetics came out with some of their Amore metallic look lipsticks, and then Jeffree Star is coming out with some, and I think Kylie Jenner also came out with some of her liquid lipsticks. So it's been a really big trend lately, and I just want to show you guys in this video how you can create your own DIY, you know, liquid lipstick without having to pay either $22, $8, or whatever. You know, if you have a liquid lipstick or something like that, or a lipstick in general at home, and you have some highlighters, then you will be able to do this DIY, you know, little metallic liquid lipstick by yourself, and you won't have to shell out any extra money, which if you're like me, you need to stop spending money. So other than that, this eyeshadow look is very, very simple. It's just really like glittery and just very simple. It's just a simple neutral smoky eye. I did put on some lashes, and I also put in a pop of inner corner, and then I just did my face as usual. And yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give me a big fat thumbs up if you do. Also, make sure you check the description box for hair info, and also links to my social media and everything that I used in this video in case you missed something. And also leave me a suggestion down below in the comment section so I know what you guys would like to see next. I know one person did put a comment saying that they wanted to see a cut crease with a Laura lash line pop of color. So let me know other suggestions or videos you would like to see so I can post more videos. So as of now, I am trying to post a video every single day of the week, so that way, you know, you guys get more videos. But if I am not able to do something like that, I am trying to just post consistently on Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays, and leaving the weekends open unless you know, I have a surprise upload, or I just cannot wait to get a video up for you guys. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys in the next one. I love you guys so much. Mwah. Bye.
Alright you guys, we're going to start this look off already with our eyes primed, and we're going into the Morphe 350 Original Palette, and I'm taking that warm, kind of rusty reddish brown shade on a Sigma E35 blending brush, and I'm just working that into my crease as a transition shade. And next I'm going to go in with those two chocolate shades. I mix the darker and the lighter one of the two on a pink martini brush set. It's kind of similar to the E25 blending brush, and I just work that into my crease just to deepen it and darken it up just a tiniest bit. And if I sound weird, I'm sorry, it is nighttime and I am exhausted. So after that, I just go back in with the E35 and just blend the two shades together. And then I go with Millionaire, and it's a ColourPop Super Shock eyeshadow. And this is one of my favorite ones. I live and swear by it. Like whenever I'm doing like a glittery kind of neutral smoky eye, or if I want something that's gonna pop on my lids, I always reach for this because it's inexpensive and it's glittery and it's just amazing. So after I pack that on to my lid, I go ahead and prime my eye, or prime my face. I'm using the Maybelline Master Prime Blurring and Illuminating Primer because I wanted this look to look a little bit more glowy and a little bit more kind of summery. So after that, I go in with my NYX pore filler because I do need to fill in my pores because they are enormous. So I just put that into my cheek areas and also my nose in the center of my forehead and on my chin, just all of those areas where my pores are a little bit enlarged, just to make those appear a little bit smaller. And then for foundation, first I go in with my Makeup Forever Pro HD foundation stick, and this is in the shade 178. And then I do go ahead and use my Urban Decay Naked Skin foundation in the shade 9.75, because it's a little bit light and I am getting a little bit darker with the summertime coming up. So I decided to mix those two foundations and blend them out with my beauty blender. And when I blended it out with my beauty blender, it just gave me the perfect complexion and it just looks so flawless. So I've been loving using that HD Pro foundation stick by Makeup Forever on my skin because it's a little bit warm and red on my skin, but if I use it with a lighter foundation, it mixes it to be the perfect shade for my skin tone. So I've been loving doing that lately. And after that, I go ahead and highlight and all of my face, and I use my Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer in deep or dark slash warm or golden, which you guys already know is my favorite concealer. Like, I live, die, swear, breathe by this concealer. It's like one of my favorites. So I go ahead and blended that out with my Beauty Blender as well, which I didn't want to show you guys because it's self-explanatory. So I just set all of that with my Sasha Buttercup setting powder, which I've been finding that I don't really like to use too much anymore, but that's a story for another day. And I just go ahead and contour my skin with my Makeup Geek contouring pans, and I use the shade Deal Breaker, and I mix it with the other one, the dark cool one, just to give me a little bit more of a shadow and a contour. And then I also make sure that I go ahead and contour my nose because I'm gaining weight, so I need to contour my nose just to give it the illusion of looking a little bit more slimmer and more defined and giving it a little bit more structure, as opposed to when I just had on foundation or when I had on concealer. So after that, I use my Anastasia Beverly Hills Golden Bronze from the Dripping in Gold highlighting palette on a Nikki Garrick fan brush, which I wanted it to be really golden and really bronze, which is why I went in with this first, and I just put that everywhere where I highlighted except for my nose. And then I go in with my blush, and I'm using my Maybelline Master Highlights blush, and this is in the shade Deep Bronze, which I just swirl the dual fiber brush all around it and make sure I get some of the pink, some of the bronze, some of the highlight, all of that in, so that way it blended in with my highlight. So I just work those two together, and then I go in with So Hollywood, which is an illuminator by Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I take that on my BH Cosmetics fan brush just to kind of really make my highlight pop and stand out, and to also kind of, you know, tie in with the bronzy shade. So the reason I used the bronzy shade underneath was to give it kind of a base so it didn't look as stark and as really bright and shimmery. And I make sure, of course, I highlight my nose. Nose highlight gotta be popping, you already know. And then I go in with Fringe by ColourPop, and I take that and pop that into my inner corner just to make those brighten up. And for lashes, I am using the Lana lashes by Huda Beauty. They are so hard to work with, but they are gorgeous. So first I go in with this NYX Slide On Glide On pencil, and I think this is in like 24 karat gold or something like that, and I popped that into the waterline. Then I figured that I didn't really like how that was looking, so I went in with the bronze shade of the same pencil and just put that right over top, and it just kind of tied in a little bit more than the gold shade. The gold shade was a little bit too stark. So after that, I go ahead and do my lips, and I'm using my Clean Color lip liner, and first I use the shade Chestnut. I get these at my beauty supply store. They're like $1.99, and they're usually right by the register. So if you guys are looking for really cheap, inexpensive lip liners, try those out. And then I go in with my Ashton Liquid Lipstick by Anastasia Beverly Hills, which is kind of like a orangish, nudish color on us dark skinned women. A lot of you guys have said that you didn't think it would look good on us darker women, but it does. It's actually like the perfect kind of coral-ish, orangish nude. So after I let that dry, I go back in with Golden Bronze, and I just pack that onto my lips. I pack it all over my lips just to kind of give it that bronzy shade. And I'm using a Sigma, like a big fluffy eyeshadow brush, I think it is. So after I pack it on all over my lips, I go back in with So Hollywood on a smaller Sigma brush. First, I highlight my Cupid's bow, and then I pack this on right in the center of my lips just to give it that fullness and to draw the lips, or the light into the center of my lips. And then I go in with some of my Bath & Body Works, like the minty lip gloss or whatever, just to give it a glossy look. And after that, your DIY liquid lipstick, metallic liquid lipstick, is complete. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up or a thumbs down if you enjoyed it or you didn't. Please leave me a comment as well, letting me know how you like this video. I love you guys, and I will see you guys soon. Bye.